طيب، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. My dear students, here I am again, giving you, hammering you with so many theories, so many topics about second language learner, or second language learners and second language learning. I hope from the last lecture or the fourth lecture that I gave you last week, that you understood what's the interlanguage theory. And also before that, what is the error analysis? To understand those two important notions, it will help you as students, and also inshallah as future teachers, to analyze the whole situation, the situation that you are in right now as second language learners, because you are still in the university. Also, it will help you to understand the atmosphere that you will be in later on in the future, in your classrooms, or maybe in your jobs, in your companies, who knows. So, in order to understand the whole profession of second language learning and second language teaching, and second language in general, we have to present you, or I have to, it is my duty to present you with all the important topics or the important notions and subjects that I feel that are important for you in order to encompass everything about second language learning. And I hope by the end, inshallah, of the semester that you will have a good dosage, يعني جرعة طيبة زي ما قالوا, from second language learning and applied linguistics in general, I hope. Now let me take you to my fifth lecture, and my topic today is going to be Krashen's, my topic is going to be about Krashen's monitor model. When I say Krashen's, one of the big names for applied for second language learning and applied linguistics in general. Okay, one of the pioneers بنا رواد زي ما قالوا. Okay, Krashen's monitor model consists of different theories or hypotheses. فرضيات. Let me take you through Krashen's monitor model in the following slides. Now, Krashen's monitor model evolved in the late 1970s. طلعت في نهاية الـ70s. It was considered to be the most ambitious theory of second language learning. That's why I chose it for you. There are so many models and theories out there, but I chose Krashen's because I felt it is يعني more comprehensible, more practical in our case, or in our course too. So it was considered to be one of the most ambitious theories of second language learning. Also, it became very popular among language teachers in the U.S., في أمريكا, in the U.S., in the United States, due to Krashen's ability. Okay, عشان Krashen خلاها, أو مقدرة Krashen's, to package his ideas in a way that makes them understandable to practitioners. When I say practitioners, I'm referring to those who are using the language, English language teachers, translators, and so on. Okay? I hope this is clear. Now, let me take you in the Krashen's, or to take you to Krashen's theory, and what does it constitute of, or the hypotheses of Krashen's monitor model. Okay, the first hypothesis is the acquisition learning hypothesis. I will talk more about it later on. Okay, the second hypothesis is the monitor hypothesis. We'll talk even more about it. Then he talked about the natural order hypothesis. ولا تنسون يا اخوان او اخوات, last time I said when I use hypothesis with I, it means singular. When I say hypotheses, معناها it's plural, okay? So this is singular. Now, the natural order hypothesis. Number four, the input hypothesis. And number five is the affective filter. When I say filter, شو معنى filter? What does the filter mean? أكيد ما فيش ترشيح. Okay? The affective filter hypothesis. Today, or in my lecture, I will be talking about the first two, okay? And then hopefully take you through the rest of hypotheses later on, inshallah, and some other lectures. Let's hope so. Now, take you to the first slide, okay? And the first slide is talking about the acquisition slash learning hypothesis. Now, what do I mean by that? Now, Krashen maintained that adult second language learners have at their disposal, عندهم في ايديهم, two distinct and independent ways of developing competence. Okay? In a second language. عندهم في جعبتهم, داخل عقولهم, two ways of developing competence in a second language. What are those two ways? First way is the acquisition. شمعنى acquisition? The Quran, the last time we talked about it, acquisition is a subconscious. تخش في مرحلة اللاوعي, almost subconscious, يعني لاوعي, ها؟ مو 100% لاوعي. It is a subconscious process identical in all important ways to the process children utilize in acquiring their first language. بنفس الطريقة اللي يستخدمها الأطفال في تعلم اللغة الأولى, اللغة الأم, okay, طلاب اللغة الثانية أو الأجنبية يتعلمون أو يستخدمون نفس الطرق اللي يتعلم فيها الطفل للغة الأم. The same procedures or the same faculties that the children use, second language learners use in order to learn a second language. And also, Krashen is saying that acquisition comes about through meaningful interaction in a natural communication setting. لاحظ أنه الacquisition ما يحدث, okay, unless there is meaningful interaction. It means, you know, there is something that I understand, that you understand, you give me, you give back, you give, take, you take, you give and take with me. It's a given taking thing, okay? And also in a natural communication setting. معنى بشكل طبيعي, في مكان طبيعي, ما يصير والله تحت ضغط معين, okay? بعض الأحيان في ناس يقول حتى في الكلاس روم, مجرد وجودك في الكلاس روم يعتبر ضاغط, إذا جاز التعبير نفسي, إذا جاز التعبير. This is what they say, this is what they claim. Also, here, speakers are not concerned with form, but with the meaning. لما أتكلم عن الفورم, when I talk about form, I'm talking about the grammar, okay? Okay, he is coming tonight to Al-Hasa, okay? He is coming now. The form, صح ولا لا؟ They are, في الacquisition, they are more concerned with the meaning. مجرد المعنى, زي ما يستخدمها الأطفال. Sometimes they use broken language, yet it's very meaningful. يعني ممكن أنا أفهم طفلي الصغير لما يقول مثلا كلام مكسر, لكن أفهم. Okay? In acquisition, the concentration is on the meaning rather than the form. Now, also, there is no explicit concern with error detection or correction. في الacquisition, أخطيت, ما أخطيت, صححت, ما صححت, doesn't make a big difference. Okay. These are the main features of the acquisition or acquisition process. For Krashen is saying, أنه في شيء اسمه acquisition learning hypothesis. Okay. خلينا نشوف learning. What does it mean? إحنا قلنا acquisition is a subconscious. Subconscious معنى لا وعي. أو لا دخل بالتلقائية. مو صعب أقول لا وعي completely, هذا فيها إشكال. لكن تجي بشكل تلقائي. Subconscious. Sub يعني جزئي. Subconscious جزء من الوعي. وليست الوعي كاملا ولا لا وعي كاملا. Okay. لكن learning, as you see here in number two, learning is a conscious process that results in knowing about language. ها process إجراء عقلي ها محسوس وعي فيه وعي that results اللي تؤدي إلى knowing about language إنه تؤدي لتعلم اللغة بشكل آخر. مميزات الـ learning formal rules and feedback. ها وش الـ formal rules؟ تدريس القواعد أو القواعد المنظمة للغة ولجمل اللغة. Formal rules and feedback provide the basis of for language instruction. هذا هو أهم حاجة في الانستركشن في الـ في الـ في التعليمات لتعلم اللغة. Formal rules and feedback والتغذية الراجعة provides the basis هذا القاعدة في قضية تعلم اللغة. Error detection number three here. Error detection and correction are central. حتى في الكلاس روم دائما نعدل نصحح هذا خطأ هذا صح هذا يبغى له تعديل هذا مفترض نسوي كذا. ف error detection and correction are central أمر مركزي تماما as it's typically the case in the classroom. I hope it's clear. Now let me take you something let me take you to a question that has been you know has been there for a long time. Okay, now can adults acquire a language as children do? هل بإمكاني أنا كبالغ أو كناس بالغين أنه يتعلم اللغة أو acquire the language not learn the language acquire language as the children do زي مثلا ولدي الصغير اللي عمره 4 سنوات أو 5 سنوات زي ما يتعلمها هالطفل الصغير إحنا ممكن نتعلم لغة ثانية. Is it possible? Let me see. أوكي. طبعا في شيء اسمه معروف انه والله الطفل لما تزرع في اي مكان يتكلم اي شيء اوكي because of المقدره اللي اعطاها اياها رب العالمين داخل عقله انه يستوعب اللغه acquire the language مش learn the language. اوكي let's see the answer to this. Krashen argued that yes, adults have access to the same language acquisition device. شوفوا كلمة language acquisition device اسمها LAD LAD language acquisition device that children use in acquiring their first language. إذن كلام كاشن إنه yes عندنا نفس المقدرة كبالغين نحن نتعلم اللغة الثانية بنفس الطريقة اللي يتعلمها الأطفال in the same much the same way that children do. Now there are critics. لما أقول critics معناها نقاد. Okay, there are critics who say واحد اسمه Greg. Okay, in 1984 pointed out that Krashen appeared to be giving the lad عطى اللاد هذه a scope of operation much wider than is normally the case in linguistic theory. يعني يقول الشغلة هذه اللي داخل دماغنا المسؤولة عن اللغة عطاها مساحة أكبر من حجمها. فهذه واحدة من الانتقادات one of the criticisms that Krashen had. Chomsky ومن اللي ما يعرف Chomsky في علم اللغة أو في العلم الجرامر syntax in particular وفي علم أيضا تدريس اللغة ككل وتعتبر من الشخصيات المشهورة جدا على فكرة في أمريكا إلى الآن. Okay, Chomsky argued that the ability to use LAD declines with age تقل مع العمر كل ما كبرت كل ما صار عمر كل ما صار استخدامك لها أقل أو تقل إمكانية استخدامك لها بالطريقة. However, لكن it is possible to learn a language after children age. لك ممكن تستخدم إيش أو تتعلم اللغة الثانية بعد عمر البلوغ by using other mental faculties. By using other mental faculties. مثل إيش؟ Logical. Logic المنطق mathematical أيضا الرياضية المهارات الرياضية والمهارات أيضا المنطقية لأن هذه أيضا الأدولتس عندهم الشغلة هذه اللي هي موجودة عند الأطفال because they have experience in life. So I hope that you are clear now about the two points whether adults can acquire the language and as the children do. To me, what I think you know, adult language learners can acquire a second language as children do, not in all aspects. يعني في الchildren في الأطفال phonologically speaking in في الارتكيليشن في الجوانب السمعيه الالقائيه اللفظيه دائما children are better than second language learners. Again, there are so many individual differences. There are people who learned the learned a second or a foreign language when they are not too old, okay, I would say old, and they excelled, they mastered the language. Lakin, if you are learning a second language or a foreign language at a younger age, it's better. It's better. عشان كذا الآن في debate صاير كثير في السعودية، هل نقدم اللغة الإنجليزية من عمر من سن العشر سنوات أو التسع سنوات في رابع ابتدائي أو whatever or no. There is a debate now going in that sense. There is one little problem there. أنه هل أقدم لغة ثانية لأطفال لم ترسخ اللغة الأولى إلى الآن عندهم ولا لا؟ This is a debate. تعرف بعض الناس يقولوا والله أنا I am afraid أنه when I teach the language I'm teaching the culture too. فأدخلهم في قضية اللانجوج والكلتشر في قبل ما ترسخ اللغة الأولى بالشكل المطلوب. أوكي؟ طبعا I have my own point of view. أنا عندي أيضا قناعتي الشخصية. But I'm not going to get into that because this is not the the time nor the place to talk about it. Now the monitor hypothesis. الآن ننتقل للhypothesis الأولى language and learning acquisition. The monitor hypothesis is what is monitor? What do we mean by monitor? Check it out in the dictionary. شوفوها في الدكشنري يا إخوان. What does monitor mean? When I monitor something, من أني أراقب الشيء. ها لا تسوي كذا. ها والله أسوي كذا. As if I am telling my brain. وهذه كلها على فكرة تحصل لنا as language speakers, as language users. When I try to say a sentence, لما أقول أبغى أقول كلمة معينة or جملة معينة sorry, I think about it. Shall I put this here or shall I put this there? Now, when I say I, shall I use am or shall I use is? If I'm using am, shall I use ing with the verb? If it's now, you got me? Okay. So there is a monitor. There is always a monitor. طيب. How often you use the monitor is the question. Would it be a good use? Would it be a... a pulling sort of يعني device يعني تسحبك للوراء. We'll talk more about it throughout the next slides or so. So monitor is the mental editor. محرر اللغوي، محرر العقلي، المنتل ها. This is the monitor. The monitor is the part of the learner's internal system. System الداخلي that appears to be responsible for conscious linguistic processing. ذكرون يا اخوان يا اخوات ايضا كلمه conscious. ايش معنى conscious؟ معناها ايش؟ وعي، في الوعي. يعني انا لما اسوي الكلام هذا معناه اني انا واعي بالشيء هذا. It's a conscious linguistic processing. Okay. Now there are two functions of the monitor. There are two functions of the monitor. One in reception, في الاستقبال. What does it do? A. When a person tries to learn a rule by reading about it in a grammar book. على فكرة reading يعتبر reception. Okay, so a reception for reading. When I study about a rule in a grammar book. Now, B. By attending a classroom. When I attend a classroom and I'm listening to a teacher, this is reception too. استقبال. Okay, where the teacher describes a rule. This is another خلنا نقول function of the monitor. أنه والله ممكن وأنا أستقبل أسوي مونيتور. لا هذا أوكي. هل هو قال كذا؟ No, he doesn't say that. Did he say that? No, he didn't say that. Okay. That's why sometimes لما يكون عندك أنت الجهاز وأنت قاعد تطالع فيلم تبغى تتأكد منه قال الكلام هذا ولا ما قال. So you keep rewinding all the time. And I hope that you're not keeping rewinding on me because I hope I'm clear to you and I'm sending my messages across. I hope so. I hope so. Two, also on production. في الإنتاج في اللفظ حين خلينا نشوفها. When a person performs a drill that requires conscious attention to linguistic form. لما الطالب أو الطالبة أو أنا ولا أنت نتكلم drill يعني شيء معين لازم نقولها. drill is a is a sentence that we have to say. Okay, when he or she says it, or when he or she says it exactly, okay, he keeps monitor. هذا صح. Does this come after that? When I use he or she or it, the third person singular, shall I use an s with a verb? Now, if I'm using s with a verb, is it in the present tense or shall I use ed with with he or she or it ولا they ولا we ولا I لما يكون عندي yesterday or last year. So if I'm using the past tense, is it going to be an irregular verb or a regular verb? So this is a monitor في production. Now B, when a learner memorize a dialogue or a story. لما يتذكر يقول والله this is what happened to me, we packed near my house and شلون اقول احنا بنروح العقير, and yes we were going to عقير beach and okay. طيب كيف اقول ان احنا مسكنا خط الدمام, now we دمام road, we took we took دمام road till we reached where, what's the name of that little city, عيون, yes, and then from عيون we took right. ويبدا ايش قبل وهو يتكلم in a dialogue في محادثه ولا في story, يبدا الطالب او الطالبه او متعلم اللغه يسوي monitor. Okay, طيب I hope this is quite clear and fine to you. Now the hypothesis, هذا هو الكلام اللي سوته أو تكلمت عنها الفرضية هذه. يقول كراشن, the hypothesis states that learning has only one function, تعلم له وظيفة واحدة, and that is as a monitor. إذا تعلمنا معناها أنه حيكون عندنا monitor أو رقابة, حيكون في رقابة للأشياء اللي احنا تعلمناها. كراشن argued that learning comes into play only to make changes in the form of our utterances. لما يجي التعلم معناه بيبدأ يهذب كلامنا, طريقة كلامنا, عكس الاكوزيشن تماما. فأنا كطالب أو كمدرس لغة إنجليزية أو كمتعلم لغة الإنجليزية أو كمستخدم لها, I have to understand that this is a normal process when I monitor. لما أشوف الطالب عندي أو الطالبة لما أدرس بكرة وتسوي أخطاء سواء كان في الكلام أو حتى في الكتابة, in writing an email, this is something that I understand, they are monitoring. ولما يترددون في الكلام أو في الكتابة, I absolutely understand what's going on, they are monitoring. لكن hey, let's not let the monitor keep you not from trying out as much as you can. The more you try, the more proficient you will be. Okay, now Krashen argued that learning comes into play only to make changes in the form of our utterances, في ألفاظنا, في كلامنا, after they have been produced by the acquired language. إذن أول ما أتكلم أنا اللي مسؤول عن الكلام, the acquired system, it's not the learning system. Okay, أول ما أتكلم أنا أتكلم the acquired system, and then learning comes in. بعدين يقول لي لا كذا غلط, ده صح. Okay, so this is what's happening in our classrooms. على فكرة الكلام هذا في all disciplines, but especially in language learning, it's very, very important. بعض الناس يقول, بعض طلاب اللغة يقول, لا لا, I'm not gonna talk because I am afraid. لو تكلمت وقلت كلمة غلط, okay, زملاء يضحكون, ويضحكون علي, وبالتالي they put me down, they look down on me, this is the case in second language learning. So I'm reading here. Acquisition initiates the speaker's utterance and is responsible for fluency. إذن أي واحد منا ومنكم, من جهتي أو من جهتكم, fluent يعني يتكلم بفلونسي, بطلاقة, بانطلاق, okay, المسؤول عن الacquired system, and then the learner or the learning system comes in. على فكرة learning is مكمل acquisition, لكن is it the same؟ هذا مسألة, يعني مسألة خلافية وفيها ديبيت كبير. Now I'm reading here. Thus the monitor is taught to alter the output of the acquired system before or after the utterance are spoken or written. Okay? I hope it's okay. قبل ما نتكلم، قبل ما نكتب، يجي عندي المونيتور يقول لي انتبه، ترى لازم تكتب I am، ما تكتب I is، نفر. او مثلا لما تكون اوريدي انت يعني خلينا نقول ملم بجميع القواعد حقت اللغه، لكن استخدام اللغه، استخدام الكلمه هذه using a word in a certain context might be misinterpreted، ممكن تفهم بطريقه اخرى. although it is the same meaning، لكن the meaning when it is employed او موظفه في هالكونتكست is different. Okay, and it might send a different message ولا a wrong message ولا an annoying message ولا maybe a threat. So using the word in its context is the is something that we can consider one of the important things and good monitor using. Good. Let me take you to the next slide. The monitor hypothesis also in monitor hypothesis also Krashen argued that the formal instruction طريقة التدريس الرسمية in a language provides rule isolation. يعني فقط تعطي، هذا وجهة نظرة طبعا، تعطي rule isolation، قاعدة الحال هكذا بدون استخدام، and feedback أيضا إيش تغذية الراجعة for the development of the monitor. على فكرة كل ما تعلمت أكثر كل ما المونيتور حق يشتغل إيش أحسن وأفضل. ممكن هذا المفترض انه يشتغل احسن وافضل. اوكي okay? I don't want you to be a bad monitor users. I want you to be the optimal monitor users. The more you use your language, okay, the more monitoring you will be do, and towards that you will master and you will be fluent in the language. Okay, but that production is based agrahina and that production is based on what is required through communication. But that production, الإنتاج أو الكلام اللي يطلع مني أو الكتابة اللي تطلع مني is based on what is acquired through communication، خلال التواصل. With the monitor، دائما المونيتور يجي دائما يطلع كذا ها. With the monitor altering production، دائما اللي جيت أتكلم يوقفني المونيتور يقول لي لا 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 الكلمة هذه غلط، لو مفترض أنك تقولها بالطريقة دي، مفترض تضيف إس، مفترض ما تضيف إس، مفترض أقول بدل ما أقول grammatical كيف أنفيها ungrammatical. أوكي ليش ما أقول disgrammatical، ليش ما أقول ingrammatical. هذا المونيتور. The more you use it, the more you will learn the language. And with the monitor altering production to improve accuracy toward the target or toward target language norms. الين توصل المرحلة اللي يقول خلاص هو الطريقة اللي يستخدمونها فيها المتحدثي اللغة. فthese are يعني the conditions, the optimal conditions and the correct way of saying things in the second language. Three conditions for monitor use. عشان يشتغل المونيتور، Krashen is saying that we need time. يعني لما يجي الطالب اوكي وتتكلم معاه، ها جيب لي الاجابه الان، tell me the answer now. Do it now. No, you have to do it. It's not going to happen. There has to be some time in order for the monitor to function. So, Krashen is saying, in order to think about and use conscious rules effectively, a second language learner needs to have time. لما تعطيه قاعدة أو تعطي الطالبة قاعدة تقول الآن تكلم عنها الآن ولا use it, he's not or she's not going to use it. Okay? Okay. She might know it. Maybe يكون already عندها المعلومة لكن she doesn't know how to say it. Or she's monitoring, over monitoring it. Okay? Number two, focus on form. لما تكلم عن form دائما ايش عن الروز ها القاعد دائما. Form versus meaning. ففوكس اون فورم، لازم عشان يستخدم المونيتور لازم يركز على القاعدة، يعني إذا ما كانت القاعدة موجودة the monitor will be of no use. So the performer must also be focused on form، يعني يعرف القاعدة. Or thinking about correctness to get his or her message across in an understandable way to the listeners. Number three, knowing the rule. يعني لما تكون ما تعرف القاعدة لا يمكن ان تسوي لها مونيتور. تخيل انك انت ما قاعد تتكلم وانت ما تعرف ايش القاعده اساسا. Will you use the monitor? You will not use it. So there are three conditions for monitor use: time, focus and form, and knowing the rule. Critics, دائما النقاد يجونا ويقولون critics. الاخوين اللي اسمهم هولستن الظاهر يبدو لي ان اسمائهم كذا في 1984 pointed out that in teaching في التدريب form should be first before time. لازم تدرس القاعده قبل ما تعطيهم الوقت. يعني ما تقول لهم والله هذا القاعده وتعطيهم وقت. It doesn't make sense. You have to teach the form itself or whatever the point اللي تبي تدرسه and then you give them time. And their study, الاخوان اللي فوق هذولا اوكي اند ذير ستدي قالوا اكتشفوا when the subjects لما يكون الطلاب when the subjects were focused on form without time pressure بدون time pressure there were gains in accuracy. بدون ما تضغط عليهم بدون ما تضغط على الطلاب او الطالبات there is gain يعني مكتسبات there are gains there were gains in accuracy في الدقه في اللغه. But when there was no focus on form, إذا ما كان في focus على الفورم giving subjects more time did not make any difference in their performance. So time is important. إذا جزء منهم يتفقون مع كراشن والجزء الآخر في study حقهم لا يتفق مع كراشن. في هوكس and others في in 1978 in their studies found out that focusing subjects تركيز الطلاب اللي استخدموهم في دراستهم on form لما يخلوهم يركزون على rules okay by having them correct spelling and grammar and written composition did not result in the use of the monitor. لما خلوهم درسوهم الفورم by having them correct spelling قلهم خيلا صحوا الآن spelling and grammar and written composition يعطوهم تعبير وفيه مشاكل في spelling مشاكل في الجرامر. يقولون حسب study حقتهم انه عطيتهم وقت ما عطيتهم وقت it did not result in the use of the monitor. Well, this could be reason قد يكون one cause or this the cause of this thing can be the way we teach. Maybe يكون طريقتنا في تعليم اللغة. Maybe it's the way we monitor students and نراقب عليهم. The way we talk to the students لما أكون معنف للطلاب it doesn't make any sense. Maybe because of the students themselves. Maybe Allah يعزكم بليدين. They don't do anything. They don't do their homeworks in the correct manner and so on. على السريع يا إخوان وإخوات, let me take you gentlemen and ladies to the monitor hypothesis. What does it say? The degree to which monitor is used, okay, depends on the following. Language learners or learners age, عفواً, learners عمر الشخص, the amount of formal instruction the learner has experienced. يعتمد كم المعلومات اللي انت تعرضت لها. The amount of formal instruction من خلال طبعا الكلاسروم. How many did I experience? This will affect the use of monitor. Okay? Also number three, the nature and focus required by the verbal task being performed. يعتمد على طبيعة ها وتركيز الشيء اللي أنا أقوله أو المطلوب مني أقوله. It will also tell me when I use my monitor and how I use my monitor. لما تكون طبيعة الجملة أو الكوميونيكيشن صعبة جدا أيضا التركيز صعب جدا وأنا لسه طالب توني زي ما قالوا غض ما بعد يشد عظمي في اللغة, أكيد أنه إيش هذا سيكون له الأثر الكبير في استخدام المونيتور من عدمه. This will affect the our use of the monitor or not. Number four, the individual personality of the learner. طبيعتك كشخص. في بعض الأشخاص كذا يعني منغلقين, عطيته وقت ما عطيته وقت مونيتور ما راح يستخدمه, أو إنه يستخدم المونيتور لكن ما يحب يتكلم ما ي... في ناس العكس تماما تشوفه منطلق تماما لدرجة انه من كثر ما هو منطلق he doesn't use any monitor, مجرد يتكلم كلام كذا يعتقد بانه هو صحيح او يعتقد بانه انجليزي او لغة اخرى لكن it doesn't make any sense. I'm here now. There are three types of monitor users. Okay. Number one is monitor over users. في ناس يستخدمون المونيتر أكثر من اللازم. في ناس يستخدمون المونيتر أكثر من اللازم. How? Those are people who attempt to monitor all the time and constantly changing their output. دائما إيش يغيرون في الأوتبوت. I am. I is. I should go. Should I go? No, I shouldn't go. They always monitor. The result is they may speak hesitantly. لما أقول hesitantly ما يتكلمون بتردد. Okay. B. No fluency. Fluency الطلاقة ها. فلما يكون over user يعني استخدام أكثر من لازم للمونيتور ما يكون عندهم طلاقة. Number two is the monitor under users. عكس اللي قبلهم. There are people or those are people who are not learned. Who have not learned. ما تعلموا بالشكل المطلوب أو ما استقوا القاعدة بالشكل المطلوب أو استقوا خلينا نقول الزبدة من شيء بشكل مطلوب. Who prefer not to use their monitor. Even if they all or if they have all the conditions. لو عطيتهم كل الوقت. The time. We'll focus on form. And knowing the rules, and they know the rules, it will not affect that much. They will not use their monitor. Why? What are the results? We'll see. The result is they are not influenced by error correction. صحيح. معطيك زي ما قالوا ظاهرة. He doesn't care that much. And B also, they do not sound right. Results for those who are using the monitor. Under, يعني using the under users of the monitor, they don't sound right. تحسن لما يتكلم, he doesn't speak English in the right way. Okay, so those are the monitor under users. The last user is the optimal monitor users, which I hope that you all or that you are all optimal monitor users. يستخدمون المونيتور بالطريقة الصحيحة. Those are people who use the monitor when it's appropriate. لما يكون في وقتها and when it does not interfere with communication. Okay. ما يتعارض مع التخاطب والأخذ والعطاء. Okay. And they use it right. وهذا يا أخوان يا أخوات يعتمد on how often you use the language. The more you use the language, the more you will be a good monitor user. The results for this type of person is two. Better communicators. ناس يتفاعلون ومتواصلين بشكل جيد أيضا more accuracy. So the more that you will use the monitor in a very smart way, the better communicator you will be, the more accurate you will be. And this is the last slide. What's the difference between the adults and children? The adult versus children difference in using the monitors. Children are thought to be superior language learners. ليش الأطفال أحسن منا? Because they do not use the monitor and are not as inhibited as older learners. زي ما الناس الكبار يقول لا ما أبغى أقول الكلام ده عشان لا أخطي. لكن الأطفال no. They say anything, they say everything, they don't care. They are not as inhibited as we are. Okay? Number two, Krashen is saying or arguing that adults are faster language learners in the initial stages, but young children outperform adults with more time. لما تعطي الطلاب أو الأطفال وقت طويل, لا, young children are much better. آخر حاجة أقول لكم مع السلامة يا أخوان, في critics. McLaughlin argued that adults or slash older learners are better in syntactic and semantic variables. الطلاب البالغين أفضل في القواعد syntactic and semantics في علم المعاني أو في المتغيرات اللي تخص علم المعاني وعلم القواعد. It is only in the area of phonological development that younger children do better. فقط في قضية, عشان كده لما تشوف واحد من الأطفال اللي مولود في أمريكا أول 5 سنوات 6 سنوات تشوفه excellent, very fluent in the English. They are doing better. It doesn't mean that they do better than adults in the syntactic and semantic variables. All what I wish for you that you're gonna be the best and optimal monitor users and I wish you that you will be fluent and accurate as much as you can by doing it again and again and again and again. And before I say bye to you, I wish you the best, and I hope that you learned a lot from this lecture. Wishing you the best, and hopefully seeing you sound and well in the next lecture. From now, all the way from me, from Al-Hasa, I wish you the best, and goodbye.